Future trading involves risk and is not suitable for all investors. Content provided in this segment is meant for educational purposes and is not a solicitation to buy or sell commodities.
Hi, I'm Joe Schmit, joined as always by Paige Driscoll, and this is Basis Loaded, the October 6th edition of Basis Loaded, where we break down the weekly NDPSR report in detail, starting with butter. This butter number at 176.54 is a really nice price. That is 2 cents premium to the CME 1 week average of 174.50. Now that 174.50 is down 6 cents from the prior week. So we had a big movement downwards in the weekly averages, and you would expect positive basis on that big down move. And that's just exactly what we got. However, it's only two over, which we would consider normal basis. What I think is concerning about the butter is that we traded 48 loads on that low move at the CME. So value buyers came in and used those lower prices as an opportunity. But that 48 loads equates to north of 2 million pounds. And here on the NDPSR volume, we only show sales short of 2.8 million. So sales at the CME are almost equal to those for the whole country. I've always been told that the CME is a global market, but that has taken things a little bit far. Disappointing volume once again on butter. And then here in the block, 178.87. That's a negative basis, minus one to the 1 week average of 179.95. Now, just like butter, volume here in the blocks is quite volatile. This is the high week at the block, 179.95. The following week, we're down 7 cents to 172.30, and then right back up to this 179.95. So on that kind of volatility, you would expect that all the highs didn't get in, so we have this minus one basis. I think in the weeks, next week, of course, we should probably have a five or six over basis. And then we'll go back to this one high 70s price in the block in the weeks to come. I think what's interesting is if you look back at the last 5 weeks in price in the blocks, we just seem to be stuck in the mud here in the mid 170s to the high 170s. So now that prices at the CME have traversed over the 180 level, it'll be interesting to see in the weeks to come if the NDPSR can capture those values and carry a 2 cent positive basis. Disappointing on the block is the volume, just barely 12 million pounds. We would expect a little bit more than that. So obviously, as prices traded close to that 180 level, buyers turned their noses up somewhat. Also, I think on the disappointing side of the card, barrels, 156.42. That's a plus 2.25 to the CME 2 week average of 154.25. So barrels have now started their trek higher, moving rapidly higher from the 148 level at the CME to 178. And so far, prices on the NDPSR are lagging a little bit. They're having a hard time keeping up with the explosive movement that we saw at the CME. Of course, you would think that when prices move sharply higher that there is robust demand for barrels. We're not seeing it here on the NDPSR, just 12.2 million pounds. So almost a full 1.2 million under what you would expect. I guess the scorecard for barrels is both disappointing price and volume. We'll see how long the strength persists at the CME. Moving on to whey, 52.98. That is essentially parity to the 1 week average of the CME at 53, and we were able to move normal volume, 4.7 million pounds, north of the expected 4.5. I think what is most impressive in whey is, of course, when we're talking about whey, we're always looking at the week prior NDPSR. That would be the week of September 18th. That week is 52.62. So the manufacturer was able to call a premium over prior week's NDPSR, which is something that we haven't been able to say in quite some time. Of course, reports, anecdotal reports out in the country suggest that whey demand still remains robust. And I think that's why you have futures trading in the mid 50s through the end of the year. We'll see if prices on the NDPSR follow along. And then lastly, non-fat, 131.45. That represents let's call that a minus 2.5 to the CME 1 week average of 133.95. This is a little bit of a pullback in the weekly average for non-fat after trading in the 120s a few months ago, all the way up to last week's high of 135.50. This is a little bit pullback on the weekly average of 133.95. We'll call it a retracement week. Negative basis is a little bit of an eyebrow raiser, but look at the volume here. Just blockbuster volume, almost 21 million pounds. So above the expected volume, and all in all, we had a tightening of basis. Certainly not the 1.5 to 2 over that you would expect. But all in all, I'd have to say that minus 2 is good. And then, of course, now, this is the low point, this 133.95 on the CME weekly average. And, of course, current values at the exchange are trading above 140. I would expect that that negative basis widens once again as weekly averages continue to climb towards the 140s and above. So this is week 1 of 5 for the October pricing period. Currently getting an October class 3 of 1785. Cheese and whey. Big factors in the class 3 pricing. All disappointments in price. So the futures are under a little bit of pressure. Current class 4 equates to 1691. So we have about that 90 cent-ish class 3, class 4 differential, which is exactly what you would expect. So the processor appears to be balanced as far as the direction of milk flows. If you look forward to November, current class 3, current CME equivalents equate to a class 3 price of 1862. Futures trading in 1860, so not a whole lot of opportunity there. And then, of course, in class 4, 1732. So that class 3, class 4 spread widens a bit with the higher cheese values that we're seeing. Now, I am not using a non-fat number north of 136 for the class 4 calculation for November. We'll see what future reports have in store for us. Until then, I'm Joe on behalf of Paige. Have a great week. Take care. Bye.